Nipsey. Check it out now. 6ix9ine this and 6ix9ine that. Niggas on my dick and on my... Yo, listen, to all my supporters, please, do not listen to all the jealous haters who are complete failures, okay? Try to bring me down by making up a lot of propaganda. However, we do have another 6ix9ine story to report, okay? Now, 6ix9ine, who currently is in the custody of the federal authorities, because he's charged with a bunch of counts of racketeering, okay? They're alleging that he was a gang member, and that gang organization that they're claiming that he was largely responsible for funding was doing a bunch of crimes, a lot of coonery across New York and other places. Now, one of the things that he had to consider when, number one, going into this case, and you know what, like, let's be clear, right? If you ask me, this 6ix9ine case or this 9 Trey or Treyway case, whatever you want to call it, this shit don't look like it's going to trial. I mean, maybe somebody who's not smart would take it to trial, but you take this motherfucker to trial, you're probably looking at a shit ton of motherfucking years, okay? So I believe a lot of people are going to take pleas. Okay, that's number one, first and foremost. Number two, if you guys are 6ix9ine fans, it'd be like, yo, let's be realistic. When do you think he might come home? Now, even if, like, let's say he had to cop out to the least of everything, a gun or whatever it is, or like some minor charge, the smallest amount of charge, he's probably going to have to do at least 3, maybe 5. But we all knew, even after he came back from that, he was on probation prior for a child sex charge. And you know what that means? Usually when the feds are done with you, the state pick you up and be like, we got you now, motherfucker. So even if he got 3 or 5, that would be tagged on with another 3 or 4 from state court. Now, he caught a break. He caught a break. And I'm going to be thinking off the cuff here because we got to use some analytical thinking when analyzing what the fuck is going on, because the feds is moving in a type of way where they're not like fucking like laying out their fucking game plan. They're bringing some shit in from left field. Now, the state, New York State, is saying, yo, 6ix9ine, you don't even got to worry about us when it comes to motherfucking that sex charge no more. We ain't trying to send you to jail. We are going to dismiss it, or we're going to consider the case closed. Not dismiss. Consider it closed and say you serve time served. Or say, basically, yo, you being in jail now, we're going to consider that you serve your time for this charge and you're no longer on probation. Now, that's a little bit of a W, but it tells me a little bit bigger of what's going on. So if you don't know, and just to really, again, simplify, if 6ix9ine beats this motherfucking RICO charge, he's completely free. He's free as a motherfucker. But of course, I don't think he's going to trial. I don't think he wants to risk 70 fucking years or life in prison just that he could say he possibly beat the case. You take a couple of years and you then move on with your life. Now, here's the thing, right? The fact that the state is doing this, I'm not saying it's abnormal, but it's telling me a little bit of something about everything going on. It wouldn't shock me if the state didn't know about all of this ongoing investigation that maybe he didn't know about at that time while they were about to lock him up. Who knows if the state didn't spare him from getting 3 years in prison for him violating or him acting up on the suspended sentence shit, because they said, why lock you up now? We know the feds about to come get you. Because as soon as the feds got him, they're like, okay, we're wiping our hands clean. We're done. We don't care about you no more. Okay? Now, it then reminds me of even one of the crimes that he's charged with. Somebody tried to make a report about the crime to the cops, and the cops said reportedly, this was on the New York Post, the cops said reportedly to that person, don't worry about even reporting this shit. We got an ongoing investigation. All I'm saying is this. Him being off of this, like, sex charge kind of is giving me a hint that perhaps the feds knew all along, or not even the feds, the state cops knew all along there was a fed case in the background that he would eventually get nabbed on, and they're saying, we don't gotta prosecute or really go too hard with getting this guy behind jail, behind bars actually, because he will be behind bars for some other shit that's even way bigger than what we got him for. That's just a theory. But essentially, if you don't subscribe to those theories, all I can say, which is the factual information here, he will not go to jail or have to go back to the judge that gave him probation for the sex charge because that case is now officially closed. And their reasoning is that he got a bigger charge with the feds. You guys be the judge. Get in the comment box. Make sure you guys like, definitely subscribe to more academics. Thank y'all for y'all support. I ain't gonna lie, the hate against me recently been wild. But chat niggas, we never fold. We don't bend, we don't fold. It's fucking chat niggas. Okay, it's Wagon Evans. I'm up.